Mile Wide project comes from the image of the distance between getting the invitations to kill oneself and actually having the opportunity to carry out the plan being wide enough that you don't do it.
There's an incremental feeling. It's like a humming in your head. It tells you you can give up dealing and that you'd be better dead.
Although the reasons why I stayed alive were arbitrary and just timing, my hope is that that these ideas and these words and this project can create that kind of space for everybody. Everybody who's contemplating ending their own life so that they won't.
And the truth is that it might be better if you could just let go. But in your wake, you'd miss a chance to let in.
This is all based on my experience of having lived through those devastating voices and invitations, having stayed alive and got to a place in my life where I'm standing in front of you today doing this thing, which is the first time in my life that I've combined my music and what you might call therapy in this kind of a way. And it's sort of a fulfillment of a broad, broad dream for me. So the fact that I've been able to do this is something that I want to carry forward.
Around you wring their hands and just ignore what they can't see. You will resolve that they can't understand. This is your chance to be.
You're going through a really tough time in your life, and I believe that you can get to the other side of it and that you will carry important information and knowledge and wisdom because you went through that to share with other people. And it's not to hang on. This isn't about you hang on through the pain. It's about realizing that that pain is emblematic of something that's extraordinary. You're not hanging on through something. It's an opportunity to explore and understand, to realize what you're most about, to realize to live as fully and intentionally as you possibly can by recognizing the relationship between the pain that you're feeling and those things that matter to you.
It might be better if you could just let go. But in your wake, you miss a chance to let in. Time you never know. May a final grip or be a mile wide. So you'll never get to the other side. May a final grip.
This isn't about making stuff that's bad positive. This is about realizing that the things that are hard for you reflect the things that are awesome about you. You hold it all. You hold the sadness too. The sadness is important.
So you can shed all the pain that you hold inside. Cry all the tears that you haven't cried. And finally learn there's nothing you have to hide. May your final grip be a mile wide. So you never get to the other side. May your final grip be a mile wide.
Somebody comes to you and they're in desperate pain. To be at the same time with them in their pain, but realizing that their pain is emblematic of that passion. And so I say to you, as people who might experience folks coming to you with that kind of pain, that if you hold it as the pain and the passion, it's easier to hold it. It's not something that you think you have to fix for them or take away from them or that needs to go away. It doesn't need to go away. It needs to be held and honored and respected. So more respect. So more respect for everybody around us. So more respect for how we're all in the same boat and we're all just one big community that created a tremendous amount of love and caring by moving away from this indoctrination of fear that we're supposed to be worried about people who are in tough spots, instead of rejoicing the fact that they've got something that they care about that much that they would feel that bad. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you all very much for being here. I'm Joel Glenn Wixson, and I'm deeply humbled. It's taken so much for us to get to this point of actually having this happen. I was talking to Shay Willard, who was responsible for actually creating this video. My wife
produced it, but Shay actually did the filming and did all the editing and took all this filming that we'd done and turned it into this amazing thing. So very grateful to him. Thank you. And to the 3S Artspace for allowing us to have this here. This is an amazing place, and in some ways it's very similar to the Mile Wide Project. It's another thing that a lot of folks didn't think was possible, and yet here it is in its glory, and it's an amazing space with an amazing gallery and a great restaurant, and it's a gem for Portsmouth to have. And so I'm very, very thankful to be here, to be able to do this here. This is the first time I've actually done this. And so you guys are gonna witness the original product and how I kinda fumble through how everything works and how to use these two mics and make everything come together. I forgot to get my guitar. And so this is kind of, if you ever see me busking, this is kind of how I do the busking thing with the piano in this position instead of sitting down. So that's new too, so I'm doing everything new. So this is the Mile Wide Project. And I get notes over here that are telling me what I'm supposed to talk about. The Mile Wide Project evolved from this song that I got in a dream that reminded me of many things that I'll get to later. But the simple idea that if the distance between when we think about killing ourselves and we can actually execute it is long enough, then it won't happen. And my hope is that we will create possibilities for people through this project so that they will also walk down a similar road and end up coming out the other side alive, as I did. And I'm very grateful that I did because of everything that's possible and that was made apparent to me afterwards, after having gone through that process, because here I am able to do this. And having come to know many of you in the audience who I wouldn't have had I made that choice. So I'm very grateful to be here. And grateful is kind of my thing because, you know, it's on the t-shirt. And I'm going to start off tonight with a song that for me is it's a kind of a prayer. It's a song that I sing most mornings in kind of a rehearsal. But I had a period of time where I couldn't sing. It was 2 months where I couldn't sing. And when I started singing again, it became very clear to me how much these words mean to me, to keep me reminded of the stuff that matters to me. In this song, there's the image of the willow tree. And the willow tree is an important tree. I don't know how many of you have actually bow drilled a fire, meaning to start a fire with a piece of wood. But a willow is a great piece of wood to start fire with because it actually it turns into embers very easily. And a lot of ancient cultures talk about the willow as the tree that actually holds the fire. And that relationship between wood and fire being something that you might think of as opposites is a theme that I'm going to talk about a lot tonight, because the tragedy of suicide is also emblematic of the things that people stand for and the passions that they hold. And it's through there that I hope we'll actually create some possibilities for folks through those ideas. So the song's called Asking for Time. Standing waiting under the willow tree in my mind, asking for time, asking for someone somewhere, show me the messages I can't find, asking for time,
I'm asking for dreams. I'm under the water, it seems. I'm lost in the shadows. Something somehow clouding the sentences that remind. Asking for time. Asking for patience, harbor somewhere to sit a while and decide. Asking for time. I'm asking for dreams. I'm under the water, it seems. I'm lost in the shadows of fear. Waiting till sometime next year. Finding a place for my heart. But now seems a good time to start. Cause waiting will just leave me standing waiting under the willow tree in my mind. Asking for time. Asking for time. Asking for time.
Thanks. If, and this is also supposed to be an interactive thing. If anybody has any questions about the lyrics, the songs that I'm singing, feel free to speak up and join in. I want this to be not just about my story, but this is actually where I'm going to tell my story. So I'm up here as a psychologist to talk about the idea that I suffered from these destructive voices of suicide. And I do that very intentionally because I'm interested in making the point that we're all, as I've said a million times to people who know me, noodles in a soup, that this is not about people who are special and people who aren't, and people who are talented and people who aren't, and people who are capable and people who aren't. This is about the fact that we are all in this together. And I'm up here as somebody somebody might look upon as someone who's got it all together, who knows what life's about, and who has everything going the way they want them, to say that that's not the case, and that I struggle too. And I believe that if we can move away in this culture from ideas that there are those who have it going on and those who don't, that we can actually create the kind of community that we can really get behind and be proud of. And so for me, This pivotal point in my life happened in the winter of 1988. And I was working for not-for-profit, and I was doing a job site supervision thing for some folks with developmental disabilities. And I found myself in a place of thinking that my life wasn't worth living anymore. And I came up with a plan, which is, you know, that's the next level of danger when you think about suicide. Lots of folks, in my experience, think about killing themselves. I actually had a plan, and I was in a position to execute that plan. And the only thing that stood between me and doing that was that I had to drive these guys home. And we were working second shift in a ball valve factory, and they would disassemble the ball valves, and I'd supervise them, and my job was to get them there and supervise their work and then take them home at night. So it was the middle of the night, in the middle of Guilford, New Hampshire, in the middle of nowhere, and my plan was to drive a truck into a tree. And I thought about how that would be a good way to do it, because nobody would get hurt except me, and which is another thing. It's another piece of this, is that as much as people get hurt when folks kill themselves, you know, having spoken to people who've contemplated this very seriously, you know, there's always that desire for other people to not get hurt, and there's always that desire for to not hurt other people's feelings. And it's this complexity that I want to bring out tonight, and with this work, to talk about how these acts can seem very selfish, and maybe in some ways they are, but there's always another piece to it. There's another piece to it that's not just about an act of selfishness. And so I want to say to you that the reason why I didn't kill myself that night is because ultimately it took too long to get the guys back to their houses. And by the time I was done dropping them off, I didn't want to do it anymore. That's really what happened. And for me, it was an arbitrary set of circumstances. And my hope is that by sharing these ideas with you as we go forward, and I kind of expound on what I mean by that, we will as a community have things to bring forward to the people in our lives who might be going through a tough time that will help us kind of understand what they're going through in a slightly different way, so that we can extend that period of time for them so that they will ultimately come out the other side alive. So that's my hope with this work. I'm gonna do another song now, and it's called Don't Be Blind, and it's about the idea that there are times in our lives when we can be walking down our path and there can be possibilities that are right in front of us and yet we don't see them. You have lost your way out along the road, and you can't see anything you can call your own, but you see the difference. See what you've made. Now you have to dig all of all the games you play. Listen to my voice as it calls you home, like a distant memory you've always known. But you have to take a chance. Reach out and take my hand if you want to share the load. Someone will understand, and baby, don't be blind. This is yours to lose. Take responsibility for the path you choose. Baby, don't be blind. Wasn't long ago, only yesterday, you weren't scared of anything, you're on your way. But you let them win, let them beat you down, let them take the best of you. When I was not around, but I'm waiting here like I've always been. Faithful as the summer breeze, you're a dying friend. Yeah, and you just have to turn around, it don't matter when. You have lost your way out along the road, and you can't see anything you can call your own. But you are not giving up until you die. You just have to carry on, you just have to try. Baby, don't be blind, this is yours to do. Take responsibility for the path you choose. Baby, don't be blind. Every single day we can find the strength inside, you can find a way. Thank you. So we come to the point of possibilities in our lives, and we look for guidance, and sometimes we get distracted by those things that come up in front of us that seem like maybe it's the right road. And this next song is called I Am That Man, and it's just a reminder to me and maybe everybody else that that I'm similarly in this process. I'm not somebody who kind of is out there in the lead. I do my best when I'm in collaboration and partnership with other people. Gate of his mind, leaving time and a reason behind. And he knows that the only convictions he has are the things that he's lost and the things that he's planned. So he stands there and waits for a sign. In the distance he thinks he can see, it's the light that he knows is the key. But it's not quite the color he thinks it should be. So he waits for a year and it turns into three, and he stands there and waits for a
shine. Don't you know that I'm that man? Don't forget that I'm that man. But he stands there and waits anyway for a notion of what he should say. But it's not the right color, it's not the right time. It is only an ever the love you will find. So don't stand there and wait for a sign. It will come to each person in turn. It's a moment that each one should learn. The gate of his mind, leaving time and the reason behind. And he knows that the singular thing that is clear is that fear echoes hope and that hope echoes fear. So don't stand there and wait for a sign. Don't you know I'm that man? Don't forget I'm that man. Don't you know I'm that man? Yeah, 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 yeah. Don't forget I'm that man. The line in that song that fear echoes hope and hope echoes fear is a very important idea for me in my life. There was a very important teacher for me named Michael White, and he came up with this notion. Actually, he got it, I think, from Jacques Derrida, the absent but implicit. And what it speaks to is this notion of combined meanings, and that in the fears, the hope, in the fears, the hope, because the fear is a reflection of what we know, and the fear is the reflection of what we know is possible. And that by not just attending to the fear, by realizing that it's emblematic of other things, we can start to see the complexity in the stuff that we go through, and the stuff that our friends go through, and the stuff that the people around us go through. And we can ask these questions. I mean, you don't have to be a therapist to think about the multiplicity of meanings that come through in the words that people use when somebody's screaming about their pain, to know that that pain is actually a reflection of their knowledge of what not pain is. And without having gone through a period of time in their life when they felt great, you know, that sadness wouldn't be there. And that we can start, you know, to ask questions into what we call the kind of these territories of understanding that a lot of times in our culture just don't get paid attention to. We are so indoctrinated in this idea of kind of labeling people in certain ways. And if we can, and my hope is that through this work, we can start to move away from that idea, you know, and here I am. You know, I'm a guy who could easily have been labeled as suicidal and depressed and who the heck knows what else. And I'm here to personally stand up against those labels, but also to stand up against labels of any kind for the folks who we know, and to think beyond those labels as a way to know more about who they are and to create possibilities for others in their lives. So here we go along this course of our lives, and we have this notion that we can have joy in our lives, and yet it doesn't seem to be there, and we get confused about why it's not there. I mean, I'm supposed to be able to be somebody who has joy, and yet there's no joy. And this next song is about how a lot of times these ideas of joy get subverted by sort of artificial
ideas and can sort of cloud the real possibilities in our lives. Plastic bags and plastic cars full of temporary dreams. Shine as bright as fireworks, though they are not what they seem. And empty possibilities come here every single day. Desperate strangers rendezvous, but they don't know what to say. And there is no joy in it. There is no joy in it. When we are bright facades on empty rooms, wrapping lies and sweet perfume, there is no joy in it. There is no joy in it. When we are painted on and patted down till the next thing comes around, there is no joy. Smiles and absent looks fill the hours without a word. Our children study chemistry, they can't remember what they've heard. Empty possibility come here every single day. And desperate strangers rendezvous, but they don't know what to say. There is no joy in it. There is no joy in it. When we are bright facades on empty rooms, wrapping lies in sweet perfume, there is no joy in it. There is no joy in it. When we are painted on and patted down till the next thing comes around. Some will study politics, convinced that other games and tricks keep us from discovering something they have yet to learn. There is no joy in it. There is no joy in it. When we are bright facades on empty rooms, wrapping lies in sweet perfume, there is no joy in it. There is no joy in it. Painted on and patted down till the next thing comes around. There is no joy. There is no joy. Whoa, whoa, whoa. There is no joy. Thank you. And so there we walk through this culture trying to pluck out the joyful moments, try to figure out how we're supposed to be, where we're supposed to be. And then solutions come along and they're not always the right solutions, and they're not always good solutions, and sometimes they're really problematic solutions, and but they're very seductive. Drugs and alcohol have a way of doing exactly what they're supposed to do. And so the idea that somehow they are empty and absent is difficult to get your head around when you're feeling deep sadness and confusion and frustration, and you know that all you have to do is take that drink or shoot that whatever it happens to be, and you're going to feel better really fast. And so this next song is about how that complexity can take over somebody's life. You put your trust in me, smile into my eyes. Your little fingers could not grasp all of the lies. Cause I am here right now,
but I am also somewhere else. Maybe most of all, I'm lying to myself. What if I'm high? What if I'm high? It's the only way right now to get me by. What if I'm high? What if I'm high? This is what I need right now to get me by. It's this bad right now, how can it get much worse? It's like my life is somehow stuck in reverse. But there's a pull on me, stronger than you know. And though it's killing me, I cannot let it go. What if I'm high? What if I'm high? This is what I need right now to get me by. What if I'm high? What if I'm high? It's the only way right now to get me by. And I know that there are things that I must do. You rely on me like I rely on you. But right now, baby, there is one thing I can say to get me through. You put your trust in me, smile into my eyes. Your little fingers could not grasp all of the lies. But I'm here right now, I'm also somewhere else. Maybe most of all I'm lying to myself. And I know that I can't handle one more day. If I give my life and yours to get away. But right now, baby, there is one thing I can say. What if I'm high? What if I'm high? This is what I need right now to get me by. What if I'm high? What if I'm high? This is the only way right now to get me by. What if I'm high? It's the only thing right now to get me by. What if I'm high? Put your trust in me, you smile into my eyes. Your little fingers could not grasp all of the lies. But you trusted me, so I will hold on tight. With your love, I just might make it through the night. And I know that there are things that I must do. You rely on me like I rely on you. But if it's up to me to make sure we get through, what if I'm high? What if I'm high? This is what I need right now to get me by. What if I'm high? What if I'm high? And it's the only way right now to get me by.
Thank you. You know, so again, in that another song about how it's not just about an escape. It's about an escape for a purpose, and it's about an escape for reasons that are very, very complicated and extremely seductive. And there's lots of traps that we can get drawn into. Some of them are about drugs and alcohol. Some are about love and relationships, and they can be just as seductive, these temptations to be pulled into something that seems like a good idea at the time. But it turns out that it's not. And so this next song is called Lion's Den. There are lies that I have told myself since I can't remember when. Lead me if I follow them to the lion's den.
to tell me if I listen close, but I can have both her and these. There's not a thing that I will lose, not a thing that I will miss, and I can sink all that I want to this lion's den, this lion's den. Can sink all that I want to this lion's den, yeah, yeah, yeah. There are lies that I can tell myself to try to deny what I know. But when the fantasy surrounds me, seems like that's the way to go. And I can sink all that I want to this lion's den, this lion's den. Can sink all that I want to this lion's den, yeah, yeah, yeah. There are lies that I have told myself, that everything will stay the same. When the things I do come back to me, there's no one that I can blame. But even in the lion's den, where the path of pain takes hold, there's still a tooth inside of me that I was always told that even in our darkest days, the sun will still shine through. Though it's been what you wait to go, it's always up to you. And I can sink all that I want to this lion's den, it's a lion's den. I can sink all that I want to this lion's den, it's a lion's den, yeah.
Thank you.
Guitar.
I've been having trouble keeping this thing in tune. So the fake solutions only take us so far, and a lot of times, even with those, you know, it's all the same. I love that because it keeps me from taking this too seriously. To understand how that everything that we do that's hard, and everything that we do that seems like a bad idea is always a reflection of our attempts to do what's right. To stay open to those possibilities in our lives and the lives of the people around us, that we're always trying to do the next right thing. And there's something about trying to do the next right thing at whatever moment we have to be in where we might make a mistake, and to not allow that to completely distract us from our intentions. Next song is called Constance Waits, and it's about how, you know, even when that path is there and that door is right there in front of us, it can be hard to go through it because there's so much telling us that it's easier to stay right where you are.
Constance Waits. awaits a raping hanging by the kitchen door. Higher states of worship, she has desperate vision. Things she hasn't seen before. His body's shaking, he's a man in need. Arms and legs are jerking, broken man by the window. Take a stand, what do you know? Hey, set me free, yeah, 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 yeah. We are bound by things that we can't always see, yeah, yeah, yeah. Have we found a place where we can all be free, yeah. Constant weights of hopes are hanging by the kitchen door. Higher states are working, she can see the answer. Oh, she can see the answer. But fear won't let her go. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
I love to talk about how fear is the real F word, and fear is the real four-letter word, and that the fear, the possibilities that are around us all the time can be the thing that really keeps us from actually going forward and doing those things that are possible for all of us in our lives. And, you know, you think about the fear that can get in the way of somebody following up with their dream, and it's crippling. But it's also, again, it's a reflection of you know, what's possible in your life. Everybody in this room, if they've ever been afraid of taking a step in their life, it's unique for all of you. It's not the same as the fear that I have. It's a completely different fear, and it's a completely unique fear, and it's a wonderful thing because it's a reflection of who you are, and it's a reflection of what you're capable of, because, you know, it's that thing that's drawing you. It's right there in front of you, and it's just asking you to kind of take that risk. You know, there's a Zuni saying that when you come to the chasm, jump. Because it's never as far as you think, and that's it's an old culture that's been thinking about this kind of stuff for a long time, and reminds me that these things that we struggle with are old things that we struggle with as a people. And so to have the faith, you know, to take that step and do that thing that seems hard and impossible. There's lots of stories in our culture about people who take that step outside the box. And there are times when we respond to those folks in ways that are less than awesome, where we think about them as different and wrong and bad. And a lot of times, you know, mostly because it's scary. And this next song is called With Eyes to See, and it's about one of those folks. Said he come down from the mountain dressed in deer skin with a feather in his hair. And the people looked upon him wondering who he was and what he had to share. And they said he walked among them for a fortnight taking shelter in the trees, conversating with the stones and saying prayers and watching leaves float in the breeze. He
he was a man. At least that's what some say. He's from the land. He walked his own way, we'll understand. Well, maybe someday, or he walks among us still and offers messages for those with eyes to see. Yeah. And the children, they would follow him, examining the things he left behind. And he did not seem to notice them, as though he had a good deal on his mind. And some people, they were moved by him, although he uttered not a single word. While for others, they were scared by him, reminding them of warnings they had heard. Yeah. Yeah, he was a man. At least that's what some say. He's from the land, and he walks his own way. Will understand. Well, maybe someday. For he walks among us still and offers messages for those with eyes. Yeah. There comes a time when every one of us is offered a vision. Plain as it seems, it's often paired with a decision. And there are those who will not question the offer. And though he might not seem like a brother. Some said it fell upon a woman at a time and place they knew it couldn't be. So they set about to punish him and tied his body soundly to a tree, yeah. And the folks sure of his innocence, possessing words they knew would set him free, were reluctant to step forward for the accusations they would surely see, yeah, yeah. That's what some say. He's from the land. He walks his own way. We'll understand. Well, maybe someday. For he walks among us still, and he can tell the ten folks telling lies, blinded by a will and on a path that will not compromise. He walks among us still and offers messages for those with eyes to see. Yeah, yeah, yeah. With eyes to see, yeah, yeah, yeah. With eyes to see, yeah.
Thank you very much. This is my bubby. People are familiar with my bubby. I always have my bubby. I love having a bubby. So there we are on our path. And there can be great long heritages of folks who have come before us, who have recognized their path and made the choice to turn away. This next song is about a guy named Jack who kind of figures it all out. Jack was born, his parents dreamed of making change, and so it seemed that Jack would have a better life than they. But as he grew, their courage failed, the work of marking time prevailed, the
freedom was the price that they would pay. Jack is 17 years old, always did what he was told, played the piper every single day, never asked for something more, he dreamt about what was in store, the way it is how it's going to stay. But there is something waiting just beyond his grasp. To see it through the haze. Jack be nimble, Jack be quick, Jack tied to the whipping stick. Jack will never step outside the line. Jack the patient, Jack the meek, Jack the never asking free. Jack the man who's running out of time. Jack is 30 years today, learn the games he's had to play, keep from driving slowly round the bend, made his mark and nothing real, I'm a stranger not to feel, found a way of love that is today, Jack the forward thinking man, in the corner that he picked, the lifestyle that he running at law through the pain, he realized he'd been tricked, and he had to start again. Jack is 45 years old, always did what he was told, paid the piper every single day. Sick of this infernal game where every day is just the same, made his mind up not get away, cause there is something waiting just beyond his grasp. Jack be nimble, Jack be quick, Jack tied to the whipping stick. Jack will never step outside the line. Jack the patient, Jack the meek, Jack the never asking free. Jack the man who's running out of time. Getting out this time. Jack is going past the line. Jack is not what they thought after all. Jack is never coming back for his pension and a heart attack. They watched him disappear and they crossed the wall. Cause he knows there's something waiting just beyond his grasp. He can't stop to see it through the haze.
That's Jack.
Got all the lyrics to all these songs in case I forgot them. But the font's so small that there's no way I could ever read them. So then the question comes. We know we have a path and we know there's possibilities, but where's the guidance come from?
The
Oh man, I hope not. I appreciate that. Yeah, well, and that's actually, so yeah. So this song's called Flowers. There's a quote in the Bible that consider the lilies of the field, Solomon in all his glory, were not adorned like any of these, and it speaks to how these flowers that we look at as beauty that's around us, they have so much wisdom in them. They come up in their beauty and they astound us and astonish us, oftentimes in secret places where you wouldn't even expect them. They fight through the concrete and they fight through the brambles, and there they are, and they're extraordinary. And then their time comes and goes, and they just go, and they don't fight it, and they have the wisdom to know that really the power is in the roots, and the roots are emblematic of all of us, and the knowledge and wisdom that we carry from our ancestors and hopefully pass on to our children as they come. And a lot of that all these songs come to me in dreams. And I had a dream last night that I'm putting in here because it came in a dream, and that's just what I do. Something comes to me, and so I put it out there, and it was about how a reminder that the branches of a tree are symbolic of what's happened. That the branches show us, that went that way. And I don't know, if you ever go up on top of a really, really windy mountain, you can see the trees twisted from the wind. And it's not the wind that just happened. It's the wind that's been going on for a long time. And yet there it is, the story of this tree growing up. And so I don't know, something told me last night that I needed to put that out today. This song's called Flowers. When we run away, we find it leads you right back to the place where you were supposed to be. When you plan your life, you find that in the end your plans don't make a difference, and you'll see. Flowers grow and die away. Take some time to look around, you see the trouble that is growing in your mind. And it don't pay rent for killing you or asking you to leave your dreams behind. Flowers grow and die away. Things will come and go. Well, what really matters slips right through your hands. Flowers grow and die away. When you run away, you find it leads you right back to the place where you were supposed to be. When you plan your life, you find that in the end your plans don't make a difference, and you'll see. Flowers grow and die away. They don't ask for another day. Flowers grow and die away. And no one gets another day. Flowers grow and die away. In this work that I do, we talk about communities of support, and it reminds me that there are people around us that can help us in lots of ways all the time. And this next song is called Watch Me. It's kind of a revolution song. It's about how there's lots of times people can tell us what we can't do and who we can't be and who we're supposed to be. And this song about some people who took stands against that.
Thank you.
Mary Parker lived on Freeman Street and liked to wear pink ribbons in her hair. Now she was a girl of 85 and found the folks around would stop and stare, yeah, yeah, yeah. But when Miss Eddie, you can't dress like that, she said, watch me, why don't you watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on and watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. Why don't you watch me? Come on and watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. Daniel Davis had a living room with windows right along the central square. And whenever he would hear a tune, he'd sing and dance and fly to the air, yeah, yeah, yeah. And when Miss said, you can't dance like that, he said, watch me, why don't you watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on and watch me, yeah, 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 why don't you watch me. Come on and watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. If we can dream about the things that we might be, we can take it all and throw it in the sea. But just remember in this moment you are free, yeah, 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 yeah. Stanley Thomas lost his job and took the news with a big smile on his face. Then he laughed and said he'd take some time and maybe even quit human race, yeah, yeah, yeah. But when they said, you can't live like that, he said, watch me, why don't you watch me, yeah, yeah. Come on and watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. Why don't you watch me? Come on and watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. And when Miss said you can't think like that, dream like that, dress like that, act like that, be like that, just tell him to watch me, yeah. Come on in and watch me, yeah, yeah, yeah. Why don't you watch me? Come on in and watch me. Why don't you watch me? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on and watch me. Yeah, yeah. Why don't you watch me? Come on and watch me. Watch me. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you. That was interesting. Watch me. You know, I've met so many people in my life who are inspirations, deep, deep, very important inspirations, whose thoughts and wisdom are reflected in the work that I do every day. And I'm proud to say that some of them are in the room right now. Actually, a lot of them are in the room right now. And it's miraculous to be here. I'm just so humbled to be up here in front of all you people who I have very special relationships with, and that you would show up tonight for this for me. It's very grateful. Thank you very much. But this next song is about the heroes that can appear in our lives, and it's a testament for me to how much they mean to me and how much I respect them. And it starts off with a little story about this guy who used to wear a suit.
Well, back in 1932, there came a man in red and blue. Folks said that he could stop a bullet with his hand. And though he came from outer space, he was committed to this place. Those people did things that he could not understand. It seemed it wasn't very long before the clever and the strong were finding damsels in distress on every street. To the world it seemed that they had brought about the only way that our enemies we sounded could defeat. Heroes, They all were heroes, and it didn't even matter who they were. But they were there for those in need, and they were driven to succeed, and they allowed us to believe that someone cared. You see, the world was such a mess, the folks around had to confess that we had bollocks it all up and lost their way. And in their haste to make it right, they had forgotten they could fight, so they ran out on someone else to save the day. Comic books and TV shows can't take the place of someone who is willing to confront the fear within. And so at last there came a day when everybody had to say, if we can't stand up to this fight, we'll never win. You see, we face it still today, 'cause it seems easier to say there is someone else around to take our hand. But I see heroes all the time, and they inspire me to find the hope and courage and the faith to take the stand, yeah, yeah. Heroes, we all are heroes, and everyone possesses gifts that make them strong. And when we bring them to the fight, we hang on to what is right. Any trouble that we face can last that long. Heroes, you all are heroes, and everyone possesses gifts that makes them strong. And when we bring them to the fight, we hang on to what is right. Any trouble that we face can last that long. Any trouble that we face can last that long. Any trouble that we face can last that long.
You're my hero. There was a second time when I faced the lethal invitation to suicide in my life, and it was right after my dad died. And bye. It's my father-in-law and my voice teacher. Interesting. Not making any assumptions there. This is a song my dad, you know, me and my dad, he was an American Baptist minister. I was going to say that he taught me about practicing what you preach. And, you know, I got to say, since I brought it up, me being up here is honoring the fact that I spent a lot of time talking to people in a box about doing this, about doing their own mile-wide project, about following their dreams, about taking a stand against the idea that the things that they want to do are things they can't do. And so it would be crazy for me to suggest other people do that and me not do it myself. So here I am, doing it. Don't ask somebody to do something that you're not willing to do yourself. But my dad, what? It's okay, I'll find out what you said later. My dad taught me, one of the most important things my dad taught me about was really close to the end of his life, and it was about faith. And it was about how faith isn't about knowing, faith is about not knowing and doing it anyway. And so this is a song that I wrote for him. I actually wrote it for my mom. The first part of the song talks about how she hears his breathing. And so just a little backstory, my mom and dad were in the den one day just watching TV and doing what they did at the end of the day. And she brought the ice cream bowls out to the kitchen and came back, and he was kind of on the couch breathing in a way that was very frightening for her, and she didn't really understand. And that was, you know, the first part of him passing. And so that's what I'm talking about in the beginning of the song. Comes now like a movie, like I am standing there too. See him here, he's breathing, and you don't know what to do. When I was a boy,
standing right beside me. I wasn't there. Without him, you wonder, is there reason to keep moving on? To follow convictions that the faithful should ever be strong. But mama, I know that he's standing right beside me. When you sit alone in your chair, mama, he's there. In each moment and in every prayer, mama, he's there. No, losing him just was unfair. And you're anywhere. If living is practice, why do some of the songs seem so sad? Sometimes the darkness keeps us locked to the joys that we've had. But look to the sky, and the stars will remind us to see. When you're anywhere, mama, he's there. In each moment and in every prayer, mama, he's there. Just was unfair. And you're anywhere. Nobody knows where the pain and the innocence go. Deep in a dream, this came to me. The sharpness is fading. Though to lose it just doesn't seem right. The sharpness is fading. Though to lose it just doesn't seem right. But mama, I know that he's standing there right beside me. And the last time you climb up those stairs, he's gonna be there. In each moment and in every prayer, just was unfair. 'Cause mama, I know that he's standing there right beside me. The last time you climb up those stairs, he's gonna be there. In each moment and in every realm, mama, he's there. And though losing him just was unfair, mama, he's there. Mama, I know he's there.
Thank you. So now to take an action. The people in my life who inspire me to do things like this and to stand up against the voices that say what I can't do and remind me what's possible. And to take up the invitation to dance.
Sun in my head and the rain on my skin. The morning is here and I'm living again. Time is a game and I know I can't win. Except if I don't take a chance, yeah, yeah, yeah. My life was a series of windows and doors, of warp on house mirrors, and vanishing flaws, and crippling fear, and the terror that roams. Told me to not take a chance, to ease the reminder that every new day is a gift to be treasured. That's one of the ways to follow your heart and all it has to say. And listen and then take a chance. Dance when you got it to dance. Come and rush with the rivers and flow with the tides. Come taste all the treasures. The living abides. Your strength is a tower that nothing can hide. Except if you won't take a chance, come stand beside me and sing for all of the wonder we bring. Day is the first day of all that will be, as far as the sunrise and tall as a tree. Your mind is a lock and your heart is the key. Yeah. If you've been invited to dance, to ease the reminder that every new day is a gift to be treasured, and that's one of the ways to follow your heart and all it has to say. And listen and then take a chance and dance when you got it too. I'm so excited too. We're all invited today. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I believe that the only force in the universe is love. And that it guides us and it gets in the way of us and it helps us and it discourages us. But it's always there. It's just, you know, you gotta remember to live fast and make it last. Let the past stay in the past. You know the only thing is love, 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 love. Live fast, so make it last. Let the past be in the past. You know the only thing is love, 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 love. There is lots of time for making trouble. There's lots of time to make yourself funny. Time just thinking about what you can't do. No matter what, we all end up the same. We live fast, so make it last. Let the past stay in the past. You know the only thing is love, 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 love. We live fast, so make it last. Let the past stay in the past. You know the only thing is love, 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 love. So don't waste your time on a worry about the things that might go wrong. You just follow down that road you feel, and you'll see that you can get along. So live fast, 'cause we'll make it last. The past stay in the past. You know the only thing is love, 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 love. So live fast to make it last. The past stay in the past. You know the only thing is love, 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 love.
Thank you.
The last thing I want to talk about is my own personal gratitude practice. There are things in life that we can't control. Being happy is great if you're happy, but that'll pass. because everything does. There's lots of things that are awesome in life, but we can't control them. But being grateful is something that we can. Taking that practice up, you know, sometimes when things get really hard for me, I'm grateful for the fact that I'm still breathing. And as long as I'm alive, I'm thinking that I'll have that. So that'd be good. So the idea of, you know, taking up the things that we can control is the practices that keep us moving in our lives, as opposed to getting connected to things that are out of our control and feeling frustrated. And so the song is called Grateful.
We all walk a road that brings both fear and fortune. We all carry gifts that burden us sometimes. Oh, and the only thing that we all have in common is a strength that just refuses to resign. I have seen it in the faces of the hungry. I have seen it in the faces of the weak. Seen it even when there should be nothing. It is this that brings me here today to speak. Know there's many souls in need of comfort. I thought I'd come here to let you know. I'm grateful for this day, yeah. I'm grateful for this day. I don't need any reason, no matter what the season. I'm grateful for this day. I can act as if my whole life is a struggle. I can act as if there's nothing there for me. Oh, I can look at everyone like they are strangers. But instead I choose to do my best to see. No, there will be times when I feel discouraged. I thought I'd come here to let you know. Oh, grateful for this day, yeah. Grateful for this day. Don't need any reason, no matter what the season. I'm grateful this day, yeah, yeah, yeah. And I know there will be times when I feel outnumbered. I thought I'd come here to let you know. Any reason, no matter what the season, I'm grateful for this day, yeah, yeah. And I know there will be times when you feel discouraged. I will be right there to lend a hand. I'm grateful for this day. I'm grateful for this day. Don't need any reason, no matter what the season, I'm grateful for this day. I'm grateful for this day, I'm grateful for this day, yeah. Don't need any reason, no matter what the season, I'm grateful for this day.
Thank you. So thank you to all of you. Thanks for the tech staff. Thanks to everybody for coming. I'm grateful to have all of you in my life and really appreciate you being here.